morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are watching me from. Greetings to every one of you according to your time. How are you all doing? May God bless you all. Happy weekend to each and every one of you. Happy weekend. Happy weekend. This is your one and only Purity Family TV. So you are welcome back again. Yes, so we thank God. To God be the glory. My people, please, if this is your first time of seeing this my video, please kindly help your sister to share the video, press the notification button, drop your comment down there below, press the like button, share it to as many as you can. May God bless you for doing that. And thanks to every one of you that have been there for me before, the ones that have been subscribing, and every one of you. Thanks so much for your support. I really, really appreciate you all. God bless you all. My people, I'm here this evening to talk about this, our Nigeria passport of 18. You understand? Because these people, the way they are doing things sometimes is really, really frustrating. I just feel like bringing this year because it's really, really somehow. Early this year, I went to do Nigeria passport in Madrid because I'm based here in Spain. I want to do Nigeria passport. I want to renew it because I need to renew it. I have to use it for so many things. You understand? My getting there, they renew the passport, this and that. They said there's no booklet. I have to go, and when everything is ready, they will post it to me as normal. That's how they do it here. You understand? I said, okay, no problem. I have no option. Let me do that. I was expecting maybe after 1 month, after 2 months, maybe I will receive the passport. Even it will not be even up to a month safe. Also, that was what I was expecting because I need to use it. The reason why I'm saying it, I believe there are a lot of people out there, they're really frustrated because of this passport issue of 18. Thank God I'm here in Spain. I didn't travel outside. I wish maybe someone is traveled outside to get that passport. Without that passport, we cannot do anything. You understand? We will all be stranded. And this one, I was not able to renew it, talkless of traveling. I was even preparing for traveling and all. But so they gave me one piece of paper like that after everything. So I have to keep it. And I left. I was hoping maybe before a month or before 2 months, I will receive it according to them. My people, I've been waiting for passport since March, January, February, March. I've been waiting. I have waited and waited and waited. I didn't see passport. Orishi, orishi. It's really where my people. I just decided to bring this year because I think it's not really fair. It's not nice because it is really affecting a lot of people out there. You understand? It's affecting people. Even me myself, it has affected me a lot because I have a lot of things to do with it. It really affected me. Okay. So since then, I've been waiting for this our passport of 18 to come. Maybe we'll come today. When I go out, I will just be in a hurry to come, or in case of maybe they come, so that they will meet somebody at home to deliver it for, so that they won't say because they came, they didn't see anyone, that was why they left, this, blah, 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 and all. I've waited and waited and waited, so I was even tired of waiting. I just said, God, what is this? So I have to go to places that I needed to present the passport. And they refuse it because the passport is already expired. You understand? So they demanded for the passport. I said, okay. I've been waiting for this passport about 3 days ago. Yeah, 3 days ago. My junior one traveled down to Madrid because from my place to Madrid is about 5 hours, 30 minutes or 6 hours before getting to Madrid. So it's not a place where I can be going all the time to check for the passport, especially with I have children. It's difficult to leave these children. I just leave them alone and travel because of passport. It's really somehow. they just have to change that thing they are doing because it's not the best. They really frustrate a lot of people, which is not nice. A lot of things are happening because of passport. Maybe you have one or two things doing because they didn't renew it, because they didn't send it to you. They will bring that thing down. It affects a lot. It's not nice. So my junior one left to Madrid. They traveled to do one or two things there, and they just called me, sir. It will go to our embassy. It's going to meet them there. I said, no, don't worry, don't go. The worst part, you will be calling there. The phone number they left, the phone number they give to you. You will call and call and call. Nobody will respond. Even when they made mistake to respond, before you know it, they will just cut it. No, even the way they approach you, oof, it's really, really no hope, nothing. It's really, really frustrating. So my little one said, ah, he's going to meet them. I said, no, you don't go, don't worry. Let me continue calling them. My brother called me again the other about 3 days ago. He said he's going to meet them. I said, okay. I said, no problem if you say so. He now left in one day. Getting there, he asked them. They said they have posted the passport to me since April or so, of which they didn't post any passport. I said, no, it's not possible. If they post that passport, I could have received it for long. I said, it's not possible. So my brother said, okay. He gave the phone to the man. Even the way the man was even talking to me, said, oh, those people, yeah, they are way. It's only way. It's God that will help us. So my brother now collected the... The man said, no, it's because he didn't pay for to post it. So she didn't pay for... I said, what? I paid everything they asked for there, because we all know now, we know ourselves, because I don't want to put much in, you understand, we know the way they do it there, which is not nice. So I said, I did all requirements, all what they asked me. I said, they were even the one that gave me, after doing it, they gave me this, keep it aside, this guy. No stamp, no Niger, no stamp, nothing to show. It's not a. I said okay. Oh. So when my brother asked, the man said, they have posted, it's because he did not pay for transfer. I said, I paid everything. My brother said, okay, no problem. How much is it? He's going to pay. He now paid them again. After doing another payment again. They not told. They didn't even give him any paper to show he paid. You understand? They just left it like that. They said she dropped phone number, my phone number, and his phone number that they will call. My brother left. I told my brother they are not going to call. I don't believe they will even call. But they called. They later called in the evening. Mm-hmm. They called, and when they called, they said, "I'm sorry, you. They have checked it." They find that they have paid. I've paid before, so now they don't know how they are going to refund that 20 euro. This life, you know, if you say the good part of it, you say it the way it is, you understand. Mm-hmm. So they say they are going to return the money my brother paid for the posting. That are they going to return the money? I was not even after that one, I'm after the passport. What I was trying to waiting to hear is they will bring it maybe a week or 2 weeks or 3 days or a day or 2 months. Let me just know, is it coming or not? That was what I was expecting, and there was nothing like that. So I said, okay.